What'd you think the boss would do with them?
Hell if I know. I look like I can read his mind.
Shut up! At least I didn't lose the kid's stuff!
Yeah, you did, you actual dumbass. Let it all fall right off the boat, too. Good thing that piece of shit boat had a net.
Fuck you, man! What about that guy that looked like the boss?
Creepy. I didn't know the boss had family.
Apparently, his dad lives somewhere around the island, too.
He does?
Yeah, we're under strict order not to fuck with the boss's family.
So why did he have us put them in some shithole shack in that swamp?
I don't know. Guess that no one here has messed with them. You trust any of these people not to fuck with the VIP, you and the bosses?
Have you clowns been messing around in my files again?
No, of course not! Someone above we're talking about!
Let that be a lesson to you. Open the damn door, I want to speak to our prisoner personally.
Yes, sir!
Oh, you sweet summer child. What the hell were you thinking? Why would you get yourself wrapped up in this? Look at you, strip bare in a prison cell. And for what, the empty promise of riches? What, you thought it was just a vacation? Oh, I'll just stroll down to Maddox Island, collect my loot, and go home. Like it's just a game to you. I promise you, it's not. This isn't a game to me. To my clan. My pirates! The treasure of the Rocky Cape Bank is ours. I won't stand for anyone trying to meddle in affairs they can't help but get involved in. The question you have to ask yourself is it really worth all this? For something that could very well be a giant nothing. Do you even fully understand what you're chasing? You know, I can tell you're a well-worn traveler. You've gone through a lot of things to get this far. I can also tell you're still just a kid on the inside. I pity you in a way. That's why I'm giving you two choices. You can forget about the bank, the island, everything. Just forget it even exists. You can cut and run with nothing lost. I'll even have my people escort you back. It's the least I can do. Should you choose not to leave, however, you'll give me no choice but to leave you here in this jail cell. I'll give you a while to mull over that decision. In the meantime, I've got some affairs to tend to over on the mainland. That red-headed moron better not screw this up.
Wicky wicky scab, boss let me up here. This is your time, you stay there, Cohen. We'll get your ass down to the hall then. Boss has got a few words for all the new people.
You scabs, shut your traps and listen up. The boss is coming to speak.
Thank you, Vance. That's quite enough. All of you are here for one reason. You had something that belonged to me and you wouldn't just give it back. Flacklin was hiding one of the keys to the big vault and, quite frankly, that's pretty damn rude. You thieving little buggers decided to hide it in your swamp. Why is that exactly? You take pride in stealing something that is rightfully mine? Must you delay the inevitable?
Exactly as I said.
I'm nervous, some of you.
Down in front! I hear you yap one more time. I'll nail your ball sack to the ceiling.
Hence, that's enough. As I was saying, what should I do to the law? You deserve to pay for your crimes. At this time, I'm going to send you all back to yourselves.
I'm not in the mood for you, asshole.
I'm not in the mood for you, asshole.
You'd best point those peepers somewhere else before I tear them out of your skull.
First assignment. Basement's full of uglies again. You look like the perfect fit for the job. If you can do the job well, I might even give you an extra meal for your hard work. Yeah, there's an equipment locker with a few weapons on the other side of this door. Normally, I'd just toss you in there and wish you the best of luck. But boss says I can't do that anymore. Used to use it as another place to shove people who ask too many questions. Nah, just fucking with ya. We use it as a garbage dump. Used to be a hell of a fight pit. Then the wall collapsed in on that old security office. Lurks killed about 30 prisoners before he got sealed off. We send prisoners down every now and then to clear the lurks out. Yeah, whatever. Get in there and clear it out. able to use that basement again after all. Oh. Well, good thing you killed it then. Figured you'd be lark food by now. Anyway, here's your reward. Get back to your cell.
Hey, kid.
Jail treating you well. I'm gonna try to bust you out of here. Sure thing. I know you're confused as hell right now. That father that Sterling keeps screaming about? You've no doubt figured out that he's referring to me at this point. Sterling's real name is Jeremiah. I managed to gain access to his files earlier to determine if I was correct or if I was just seeing ghosts. Sometime between when he was taken from me and months ago, he managed to, with his crony Shillin and Pence, round up this group of raiders and create the group known as the Sterrek Island Pirates. They don't venture far outside of the territory either. They stick to this island chain. I've been here on Maddox Island since 2247, keeping an eye on the Rocky Cape Bank, waiting for the perfect time to again attempt to gain access. It's basically become my life's work. I came here years ago with three others, but things went sideways when we first made our move. Not even sure Jeremiah realizes I'm still alive and on this island, nor do I believe it would be a good idea for him to discover this right now. I disguised myself as one of the prisoners they hauled over here along with you. Neither Sterling or his sidekicks know what I look like, so I was able to blend in with the crowd. It's probably the only time I'd ever be thankful my own son doesn't recognize me. Taking a look at the jail and its security, I've narrowed it down to two actual escape options. First, the stealthy option. I can sneak into the pirate supply closet on the first floor and grab a few stealth boys for you to use. The only problem with that is you'd be on your own. I'd have to sneak out a different way to minimize the chances of detection. And then there's the distraction option. I rig up explosives in the vent shafts and detonate them. The jail has a security feature from before the war that opens all the cell doors should a blast happen. The prisoners are probably riot, which lets you escape mostly unscathed. You want to try to sneak out of here? Since the guards won't be distracted, there'll be more of them to dodge. According to the patrol files, it'll be doable, but not easy at all. Is this what you want to do? Okay, sneaking it is. I round up a few stealth boys and put them in my cell underneath the bed. You'll be able to exit your cell to grab them and sneak out. Your exit point will be the south side gate. There will be a boat you can use to leave the island. Good luck, kid.
Thank you.
kid.
Glad to see you finally made it off the island. I had confidence in you being able to get out of there. I'm surprised those pirates didn't put up more of a fight. Usually no one makes it to the beach without being covered in bullet holes. Seeing that many of them in the old jail leads me to believe their numbers are stronger than I initially expected. I knew they were holed up there, but I honestly didn't expect that many of them. And to think that's where they hauled off what was left of Flackless' population just because the pirates thought they had a key card. It's a tragedy to think all those people may not make it off that island when home is so close by. My full name's Jimmy Goldman. I've been living on this island for about 29 years now, keeping my eyes on the bank and anyone who gets near it. I originally came here with three others, but I haven't had any contact with the other three since we originally attempted a raid 25 years ago. I mainly just stick to my little cottage near the exit and tunnel to Meridaport. No one bothers me out there. You met Elizabeth, my youngest child, and by now you've met one of my sons, Jeremiah, who goes by Sterling, as you know already. To think Jeremiah is the leader of the pirates. I didn't really get to watch him grow up, and even then I didn't think Jeremiah was this twisted. I only wish I could have kept up with him. In a way, I'm just glad he's still alive. I wish I knew whether or not Zachary was, though. Wait, really? Wow, I'm gonna have to confirm this myself. I can't believe it, both my boys are still alive. Hold on, did you get a name? Ralph Moritz. I just can't believe that old bastard is still kicking. And I'm guessing he didn't tell you the entire story either. Yeah, he probably didn't mention how he ran like a scared little asshole while Mary and Ian and I got shot up by a bunch of drugged up idiots. We got away, but I lost contact with Marion and Ian shortly after. Never heard from any of them in a long time. That chicken shit, Ralph. Never once tried to reach out and to think he actually came back years after the fact. God damn it, Ralph, I'm gonna wring your ass out when I catch you. Well then, I guess we need to head there, right now. It's time to deal with Ralph. He screwed us up a big time way back then. He needs to pay for his actions. Yep, even knowing about the people of Flackland, I truly don't believe Jeremiah will actually harm him or his new friends. We have time. Ralph needs to be dealt with first, and I absolutely must find Marion and Ian. I'll give you what little I have on them, but after we take care of Ralph. I told her not to follow me out here. Elizabeth, what are you doing out here?
I've been waiting out here for you since you left for Sterrek Island. I want to help you get into the bank. I didn't get a chance to mention that before you went out to the old jail.
Oh, Elizabeth, you don't have a goddamn clue what kind of mess you were getting into.
If I really didn't, would I be getting involved now?
You really are as stubborn as your mother.
You tell me this all the time. I know.
You better believe it. Fine, just stay near us. Now that I think about it, you're as tied up with this as I am at this point.
What do you mean?
You remember the twin brothers I told you about, the ones you never met before?
Yeah, I do. What about them?
Turns out they're very much alive and they're closer to home than we both thought. Jeremiah Sterling, leader of the pirates. And Zachary came here with a group of explorers, one of them being the kid beside me. He goes by Eyes now, apparently.
Holy shit. I can't believe...
Believe it, Liz, but before we go to Greenwood to rescue him, I have some unfinished business in Meridaport. Ralph Moritz, to be exact.
You mean that asshole is actually alive?
Yep, we're headed to Meridaport.
Yeah, let's go.